Guys, are we ready?
Yeah.
Hey, guys, this is it. All right? We're undefeated as of right now. You guys got to go out. You got to take control of the game. Okay?
Yeah, guys, set the tempo right now. You hear me? This is kind of like, this is the game that's going to open some eyes to all the other teams out there. So, you know what? Go out there strong. Finish the goals. Finish opportunities.
Saw out there in the first half.
You guys look like you haven't even been on the field before.
You guys need to realize, you know what? I've got 20 other people that would love to be in your shoes right now, would love to be wearing that jersey.
You've been doing this since you were in the Lollipop League.
Simple thing to do, guys, and you're messing up.
I need to know if I've got guys that are going to go out there and get it done in the second half. If not, you let me know right now. I'm not going to put up with it anymore.
Don't we get treats at halftime?
You should feel special that you're able to be on the field.
Now, are we going to get it done in the second half or not?
Cody, I'm not going to Northmont.
What do you think about the performance of this team?
Well, I just thought we would have had more goals by now, I'm going to be quite honest with you. But sometimes it's difficult to play a weak team like this.
Hey, they cut my interview off.
Alright, back on me. Alright. But anyway, sometimes it's very... Where's my microphone? Sometimes it's very difficult when you play a weaker team like this because they just tend to pack it in and can't penetrate the, you know, the defense that well and score. So.
appreciate.
ESPN Deportes, el viernes partido de Northmont contra Springfield North.
Steve Bauer, and I'm number four.
Over. I'm impressed because he wasn't in any fights this year, so that's always good. He makes up for his size with his heart and does his speed. He's pretty fast.
I'm very proud of the way Steve concluded the season. The whole season, I know he was really frustrated about not playing. At the end, when he came in, I thought he did a great job, and I'm proud of you.
Well, really all I got to say about Steve Bauer is that he has the tenacity of a hedgehog from the southern hills of Ethiopia. Thank you.
I'm Jordan Shanning, number 22.
Let's go, dude.
I think that crack is like scissors because he cuts a lot. He cuts with the ball.
He puts his heart into everything he does.
Sometimes he's vicious, sometimes he's passive. Guess it just depends on the day.
All I gotta say about Jordan Shanning is that he does not have the tenacity of a hedgehog from the southern hills of Ethiopia. Thank you.
I'm Kerry Sigbart, and I'm number 10.
Kerry Sigbart probably said some of the dumbest things I've ever heard in my life, but he also said a lot of smart things, if you can believe it. Being a keeper, you got to be real vocal, and I could always count on Kerry having his mouth open, you know, in one way or another.
Kerry Sigbart is probably the biggest example of a lack of self-control on this team. But at the same time, he's probably the biggest example of having the most love for the game. I don't think I know anybody on this team who loves the game more than he does.
And, you know, if you get beat and they score on you, he might, you know, punch the post and come and headbutt you or something. Like, so, I mean, so it's another incentive not to let him score with Kerry back there.
I'm Ryan Fleming, and I'm number 11.
But he's probably one of the most reliable players we had on the team. He always got his job done, and he always knew where he was supposed to be. He's always thinking on the field. He was a great player this year.
He's a beast. He was dominating the outside all year. He shoved Matt Chin to the ground, and I think his mom's giving him money for that now, so that would be the highlight.
I think Ryan really stepped up this year, and before last year he didn't really talk that much, and this year it was totally different. He screamed out there until he got the ball, and I think he's one of the most improved players on our team.
Proud of him because every time he stepped on that field, he played with his heart. Every second he was out there, he played well, never made any mistakes, and he got the job done.
I think you're so solid this year. Like, even had a couple moves in there this year, you know. Last year was kind of like, you know, maybe like straight up and down, but this year was like a little bit of that, you know.
He played well, and he played with a lot of heart. He even dove at the ground head first for a ball, scraping his little chin, and he played hard and good. It was great.
Come on. I'm Nick Parenti, and I'm number 14.
Nick, I can kind of relate to Nick because we both like to hit people really hard. So he's a great defender, and it was great playing with us this year.
Yeah, Nick had an unfortunate year, I guess I would say. I'm just really glad he did come play, because I know at the beginning of the season he was contemplating not even playing, but then he came, and I know we're all happy he ended up playing, because he helped our team out a lot.
I'm real happy Nick decided to play this year, because we used him quite a bit, and he made a lot of big plays for us. Over the past 4 years, he's always played a solid part in the defense. So I'm real thankful that he came to Northmont, and I'm real thankful that I got to play 4 years with him.
Without his mom, I wouldn't have any pictures of me, so I'm glad he's around.
Jim Inkrat, and I'm number 19.
I give him props for every game, every minute he got in, especially the Sydney game. He was awesome.
Well, Jim Inkrat is probably one of the last people I'd like to see in the dark alley at night, because he could rip me apart limb by limb. That's all I got. I'm so scared of him.
I'm just glad Jim is on our team, because I really don't want to play against him, because he hurts you. I'm just glad I don't have to play against him, because he works really hard.
He's very strong. He's not scared to push you off the ball, and he does a crazy little head ball where he
turns his head and like
goes like that. It's pretty sweet. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Greg Malika, number 16.
The most entertaining person to watch play. From the trash talking to all the other players, to him just saucing up left and right players on the other team. Every game, I came out there waiting to see what would Greg do next.
This year, like the trash talking, him and Jordan just was so funny. And when he Maradona the person on the line and didn't go out. I don't know, just stuff like that. Greg is just a beast and a funny beast.
He's a lot of fun to play with. He's crazy, just his moves are insane. He'd go the entire length of the field just saucing people up every 2 feet. And it was just a heck of a lot of fun to play with him.
Is it on? A little bit of this, that. All right, cool. You want to do a dance?
Oh God, the Greek sensation. What can I say? He, even if the chance of him pulling a ridiculous move was, you know, slim and none, he would do it anyway, and more than likely pull something incredible. And then we would all just stare and watch him as he gracefully soared through each of their players down the pitch like a heron swooping over the Mediterranean, gathering carp for their young. Grand Elder, 17, forward.
Throughout the whole season, I remember being back in the back of my box, and he taking a shot from 20, 30, even 40 yards out. Embarrassing the other keeper, just ridiculous shots that put us through to win games, tie games, you know, just even goals we wouldn't even need them, just be miraculous.
Had a lot of sick goals like Carroll and Fairmont. Oh my God. I mean, I remember sometimes like I'd be like, oh God, why is he shooting it? And then it'd be like sick and go in, and it was so worth it. So I thought he did sweet this season.
Grant has some amazing shots, and he also has some pretty unbelievable footwork.
You know, he'd always be like, oh, why is he taking that shot? Or why is he going to dribble towards those people? And I'd be yelling for a drop or something, be like, you know, Grant, drop. He'll just turn and shoot it, and I'll be like, you know, what are you doing? And it'll go in. I'm like, oh, good shot, you know. That's the way to do it. And, yes, I mean, I play club with him, so I see a lot of that stuff a lot. It's kind of miraculous, actually. And if he compared me to a heron with carp, I'd have to say it's kind of like a monarch butterfly floating through the air just looking for a peaceful place to nest, you know? And he'll find it. He'll find it.
I'm Sean Davis, and I'm number two.
Even if the day was going bad, you just have a good day after playing with Sean. And when he wasn't there, we noticed it. Like, in games where he wasn't there, you could just tell the middle of the field wasn't controlled by our team. And so it was just great playing with him this year.
One of the best soccer players I've played with in a long time. He's on my club team, and I just love playing with him. I rely on him in the midfield for everything. He gets the job done.
Sean... one of the most solid players I know. Like, he always controls the middle. I have a lot of fun with him, I must say. In practice, have some good times. And a little known fact about him is that he makes a mean, strong bully. So, Sean, I love you.
Cheesy chicken. He's like Cheez-Its, and you put like sour cream on the chicken. I don't know.
Oh my god, he better not put that on the thing.
Cheesy what?
Shut up.
I made a sweet chicken.
Hey, Sean played great this year. He's always a great player. After the second half of the year when I moved back into the center mid position, I had a lot of fun linking up with him. I thought we played a lot better.
Hi, my name's Jordan Rose, and I'm number 15.
What can I say about Jordan? He's solid, man. He is good. He's a good player. Dominates the air. Stops just about everything that tries to come through back line.
Jordan is a good player. He's real big.
He was kind of the glue that held the team together. Without him, the team would have been completely different, and just wouldn't have been the same without him.
Jordan Rose, many, many, many of times has saved my buttocks back there in goal.
I've probably known Jordan the longest of anybody else on the team, and he's just a natural leader. You can just tell by how he walks around the field, and he was captain of the team as a junior, which is really rare. He was the backbone of our team, and he just really held us all together, and he just kept everything solid in the back, and he's just a great person all around.
He's way too tall.
What's up?
What's up?
What's up?
That's good.
How's everybody feel today?
Good.
You guys know what this game's about, right?
Winning.
It's about winning. It's about your future when it comes to, especially for you seniors, high school ball. We definitely got our work cut out for us. Got to make good decisions in the final third. We've got to put away our chances. You've got a special guest here today, Avon. And you want to say a couple of things?
Hey guys, I've had most of you in camp, and when Coach Spur called me and said, "Would you like to make it this time?" I was screaming on the phone, "Yeah, I'll make it! I want to see those boys play, man! Because you guys got this far, I'm very proud of you. You will win tonight, and you will win if you are number one, unselfish. Don't scrap, don't fight, don't try to do it all on your own. Win with war in numbers. Whoever is behind that ball, right fullback, stopper, or left fullback, get up and become another midfielder. So now you are winning with numbers. You could play as pretty as you want, and if you don't score goals, you're gonna lose. So when you get on the field, with all that said, you have to be thinking about scoring. You can't just be thinking about playing pretty and being effective. That's not good enough tonight. You have to score. So how do we do that? Every set piece, every corner kick, every free kick, you're in the goalie's face. You rub shoulders with them. You don't know you're there. They're defenders. They have to feel the physicality of you. You have to be in them, on them, around them, everywhere. You're a cobweb. Wherever they move, you're in their face. Don't play away from them, play in them. Get in their head and score. You'll win tonight.
Let's go get it done.
Go, boys!
Press people button.
Nobody chat come face me with some. Like only have 22 in a me something. Then I feel so forget the next dozen fool. Press trigger me no press people bun. Nobody chat come face me with some. Like only have 22 in a me something. Then I feel so forget the next dozen fool. Anytime you ready to know this is my one. See you cause it's pretty tough but from the sky.
Is the bomb, di di bomb, di dang, di dang, di gi di gi. Come on, one and three with the bomb, the dang, the dang, diggy, diggy. My style is the bomb, the bomb, the dang, the dang. Come put man for free. Remember when they leave you in a pool of today. So you need to do what you want. It's a lot of fun and fun. Find the style is the bomb. The bomb, the dang, the dang, the dang, the dang.
Trigger me no press people button. Nobody chat come face me with something. Like how me have 22 in a me something. Game say them a friend and them bad mind me friend. Anytime they ready for
yeah. Anytime start. One or two take a long speech from the sky. The style is the bomb, the bomb, the dang, the dang, diggy, diggy.